Okay, so gonna pop up to exit real quick. Okay, so it's 6:31 PM on Monday, June 1st, 2020. We're gonna call the St. Albans Town Selectboard meeting to order. We're gonna start with the Pledge of Allegiance. I'd like to lead it tonight, and then we're gonna have a little chat after that. So let's give the pledge. I'm gonna stand up. I have an American flag like pillow over there that I'm gonna give the pledge to. So, all right, all together now. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And I wanna highlight for all. I do wanna have a quick discussion about what's going on in the country. We saw last week the murder of George Floyd and everything that's been sparked out of that, the peaceful and then violent protesting around the country. And a lot of people might think that this type of discussion doesn't really have a place in the Town of St. Albans Select Board, but this is as much a race issue as it is an excessive force issue in my mind when you're talking about us as municipal leaders and what we owe our constituents. We owe it to them that their police officers never use unauthorized excessive force. And we owe it to them that our police services are executed in a safe, unbiased, equitable manner. And I wanted to remind us all that that's our duty as we work through the police contract discussion. And this issue and this murder, which it is a murder. I don't know if everybody's watched the video. This, it's hard to talk about after what. Murdered over being suspected of forging a check. It's ridiculous. I have probably 5 to 10 mini storage tenants who bounce a check on me every month, and they don't even get anything beyond a mean letter from me. I mean, that is ridiculous. Murdered over being suspected of forging checks. I want us all to remember as we move forward with the police contract and our discussions with whatever agency or office that we decide to move forward with, how we wanted them to explain in their proposals how they would police the drug epidemic it's an epidemic in our community. We need to give the same focus to how they train their officers and how they make sure that their officers' mental health is in as good a place as it can be as they execute their duties. We cannot allow a situation that allows for excessive uses of overtime to cover open positions, putting officers in a disadvantaged position. We've got to do everything we can to make sure what happened to George Floyd doesn't happen to one of our constituents. God bless his family, honestly. Unless anybody like to add anything to that, let's move on to amending the agenda, but I'm more than happy to welcome any additional comments from anybody on that topic. So we've got two additions to the agenda. They both could live under agenda item number 6, which is the town manager's report.
Actually, sorry, I'm just going to amend that. The water and sewer request was rescinded. They're going to come next time.
Okay.
And also, I just need to know who Galaxy Note 10 is for the minutes.
Is that us?
Yeah, it's Tyler Whitcomb, Frank Whitcomb Construction.
Oh. All right, thank you so much.
Okay, so we have agenda item number 6. We'd like to add paving bids as a bullet point, if somebody would make that motion.
I'll make the motion to add paving bids to tonight's agenda.
Okay, and a second, someone?
I'll second it.
Jessica beat you to it, Jonathan. You got to be faster than that. Okay. I know. All in favor?
Aye.
I heard one aye. I need, okay, that's 2.
Aye.
All right, that's 3. All right, we're good. So, moving on to warrants. Stanley, you have the general fund, I take it?
We're on the warrants. We didn't make, we need a motion to make an amendment to the agenda.
We did that.
I think paving bids.
I think that's what they did, but I couldn't hear him say the paving bid part.
I didn't hear a word.
Yeah. So they
we did it.
I made the motion to add paving bids to tonight's agenda.
And it was seconded by Jessica and voted in favor by Jessica, Aaron, and Jonathan.
Okay.
I'm an aye.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. 4-0.
So you want to do it after warrants? Is that what you're doing?
No, we put it under your report, under agenda item number 6.
Okay, I couldn't hear. That's where it is. Paving bids? Okay, I didn't get a revise. All right. Sorry, okay, we'll get it.
So we have warrants. Stanley, do you have the general fund?
I have the general warrants and general warrants for 6/1/2020 was $14,871.38. And it was across all departments. There was one department I could not find in our log, so I called Trusty Jen and she put me straight. It's the employees contribute part for their Delta Dental, and it was $428.44 to 10-200-1. So she explained it. I'm okay with it. So I would make a motion to accept the warrants for June 1st, 2020, in the amount of $14,871.38.
I'll make a motion to accept.
He made the motion.
Oh, he made it. Oh, I second it.
Okay, perfect. Thank you, Aaron. Thank you again, Stanley, for the thorough explanation. We appreciate the work that you do and the explanations you give us every week. It's always good to know. No matter what's going on in the world, we can count on you to come through with a thorough explanation of our general fund warrant, whether it's $114,000 or $14,000. So we appreciate it. With that said, all in favor of Stanley's motion, please say aye.
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 Okay, perfect. 4-0. All right, so we've got the Infrastructure Development Fund. We've got a warrant dated June 1st, 2020 for $1,106.50. Which is one invoice to Cross Consulting coded to the salt shed. So we need a motion to approve that.
I'll make a motion. We approve the infrastructure development warrant for $1,106.50.
I'll second it.
Thank you. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, perfect. Now we're gonna go to payroll. We've got the payroll dated May 22nd, 2020. In the amount of 18,000.
We had one more part, bill, industrial park.
I know, but I'm gonna do the payroll and then I'm gonna go to that one. I'm just doing them in order that they were sent in the email.
Oh, okay.
I've got them. Don't all worry, right. we pay all our bills in the town of St. Albans.
Oh yeah.
But first, before we pay our bills, we've gotta pay our people because they're more important than anything. May 22nd, 2020, in the amount of $18,791.24. I've got another warrant. I'm going to open that, and we can make a motion to approve them both at the same time for payroll. So we've got payroll dated May 29th, 2020, and this amount is $36,239.96, which includes benefit packages and associated costs. So if we can have a motion made to approve both of those warrants, it'd be great.
I'll make a motion. We approve the payroll of May 29th in the amount of $36,239.96 and the payroll of the week, May 22nd, 2020 in the amount of $18,791.24.
Who's going to get to this? Aaron barely beats Jessica out. We saw both unmute. Boom, boom. So, okay. Motion has been made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Perfect. All right. Now we've got another industrial park warrant. Thank you for the reminder, Carrie. They're Drumac invoices for the industrial park. Alan, what's going on over there? $3,990.32. I thought we were done with the days of $3,000 Drumac invoices.
Some of them are from last October, since Wind River took over Drumag for whatever reason, the bills weren't getting to us. So if you only see two of the bills were for a cleaning this year, which was almost 10 months since we've had over homes.
Brock, Sheriff, could you mute your mic, please? We're getting some back feed. All right, Alan, sorry to interrupt you. Go ahead. So that was, they're just some older invoices.
They're older invoices that we never received. No, the pump systems, the new pumps are keeping the tank a lot cleaner without having to do a cleaning. We just recently had it. So two of those bills were for the fine cleaning.
Well, thank you very much for the explanation, Alan. I feel a lot better. And great work on making, on getting those pumps installed. And great work to Anna for all the work you did to set up the loan repayment and all that. Those pumps are fantastic, and they've saved us a fortune already. So with that said, if someone could please make a motion to approve the industrial park warrant dated June 1st, 2020 for $3,990.32. Be great.
I'll make a motion. We approve the industrial park warrant dated June 1st in the amount of $3,990.32.
I'll second it.
Jessica, by a nose this time. Aaron was drinking water. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. It was strategic. Perfect. Water drinking. Yes.
So you're ready for the next second? All right. So we're done all our warrants. Let's move on to minutes. So does anybody have any notes or corrections for the minutes?
And we're just talking about the minutes from our last meeting, not the bonus meeting.
We are talking about everything in our packet.
Okay. Because I read the ones from our last meeting. And I think Jen sent out additional minutes from the shorter meeting that we had. So I haven't had a chance to read those minutes, but I read the other one. So
all right, yeah, you're right. You're right, Aaron. Let's talk about the, okay, so what we had in our packets was Monday, May 18th. It started at 5:30. And yeah, so that's all we're talking about tonight.
So it was your Aaron, second meeting of May, the regular scheduled meeting.
Right.
5:18.
Yep, that's the one they're talking about. Did you have any changes?
I didn't come.
That is correct.
So, anybody have any changes? Seeing no hands fly up or no mics unmuted, take a motion to approve.
I'll make a motion to approve the select board minutes from Monday, May 18th.
And a second, anyone?
Second.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Perfect. Thank you. So that's it for minutes. Public comment. Is anyone here to make a public comment? Okay, seeing no microphones unmuted, we will go on to agenda item number 6, which is the farmer's, it's the town manager's report. But item number 1 is why we have Jonathan and Alan here with us. It's the farmer's market and a general update on parks and where we stand. So with that, I'm going to mute Alan, John. Great work in getting everything started up. Everything looks beautiful. Take it away.
I'm going to leave it up to John since he's the market manager. He's also overseeing the parks. He and the crew are doing an excellent job. We got a lot of our college kids back this year. We got a couple extras, so he's got a really good crew, and they're having some fun. So I'll leave it up to John from there about the market.
First farmer's market went good. It seemed like we had a lot of customers came through. We still don't have our full vendors yet, but it'll be working up soon. We had one calling sick, and I think I have 5 more that are coming on. Either they're postponed because of the COVID, or they are self-quarantining because they're from Florida or vacation in Florida, and then they come up in the summertime up here. So, but We did a one-way all the way through. Kept everybody 6 feet apart. Vendors were 12 feet apart. It was a lot of measuring.
Yeah, no, and we appreciate that you've blocked off the playground area in Bay Park and kept the rest of the park looking beautiful and usable. Very responsible. It's a good decision. Do you have any other updates on the opening of Cohen Park? Anything park related that you would want us to know at this point, John and Alan?
Cohen Park's open.
Okay. That's good. Hey, that's what we were hoping to hear. That's great.
Because of we had some ice fishing guys tear all the lawn up this year, so but as soon as we get the hay off that, it'll look pretty nice.
Perfect. Does anybody have any questions for Alan and John on anything park or farmers market related? All right, seeing nothing. Stanley, do you have anything? I don't want to leave you out. I know you're not. Okay, perfect. So,
Alan's here, and could we do the paving bids now just to get them out of the way? Because I don't know if he's going to be able to stay for the whole meeting.
Hey, this is your report. Whatever you want to do.
All right.
I can do that. So we did put out the paving bids. We put them out to five contractors. Two contractors actually put bids in. They should have been all in your packets. Pikes and Wickham are both the bidders that bid this year. Hutchins, SD Paving, or SD Ireland, and ECI didn't bid. So, I thoroughly looked over both bids. I did make a spreadsheet. They should be in your packets. So I broke it down. I had my own assumptions on tonnage and coal planing averages and stuff like that. But as you can see, when you break it all down, Wickham's was $2 a square yard for the coal planing. Pikes was at $1.25. Paving wise, for our streets, this is Wickham's was at $67.65 a ton. Pikes was at $65.75. Packages are different. Usually when there's paving going on, I keep a close eye on it, so I think the packages will come in a little different. Bid number two, reclaim and pave French Hill. Wickham's was reclaiming for $3 a square yard with paving at $63.80. I better wear my reading glasses. $63.68 a ton. And Pipes was $1.25 for reclaiming at $65.75 a ton for the asphalt. And then on bid three, the top new garage, Wickham's was $70.53 a ton. Pipes stayed at the $65.75. So looking at overall the tonnages and prices per unit, I would award this bid to Pipes.
And for clarification, there's representatives from both of those companies online.
Right.
If you have any questions.
Carrie, you don't need a motion from us to confirm Alan's bid.
I do not. Decision. No, it's just this is one of those
the notification.
Things that, correct. Well, in town, people are very, very interested in when and where we pave and how much we pay for it.
Well, it's the biggest contract that we award every year.
It is.
Year in and year out.
Yep.
And then we're also concurrently working on the biggest contract that we have, which is for a totally different service, but still. So does anybody have any questions for Alan on the paving bids? Is anybody not satisfied with his choice and wants to make that known?
I just wanted to, so reclaiming, if I'm understanding it, that's grinding up the asphalt that's there and then reusing it on the road, or is it something different?
Reclaiming is kind of like tilling your garden. You're actually grinding the asphalt right down to the dirt level. You're putting it back into a gravel state, and then you grade it off, roll it, and then pave over. Coal planing is when you just grind just the surface. So like last year, we started with the coal planing our streets. So we took an inch and a half off, put a new inch and a half back down. So I'm still doing that because the coal planings are great for us to do bike paths. They're good for parking lots. They're good for roads and whatnot. What I plan on this year is the section of French Hill. I'm replacing a bunch of culverts that I got grants on, reclaiming it, putting it all the way down to the gravel. I'm going to add grindings on top of that and then some virgin material, and then they'll repave it. So hopefully we can take care of one section of French Hill so we don't have the heaving anymore that we've had.
So this process would remediate some of the problems on French Hill. Wouldn't solve all the problems, but just kind of get us to a better state in the temporary?
Yeah, this will take care of, it should take care of at least a quarter mile of French Hill, the worst part, one of the worst parts. I think this is a good way of going about it. I'm hoping if this works out great this year that we can do a little section each year until we can get that road rebuilt the way it should be. And then in the meantime, still keep up with our roads in the town so the town taxpayers see that their roads are staying on the schedule. After this year, with the streets that we're doing, pretty much the whole south end of the town will be done. We'll be focusing more down in the bay probably next year. So we're in a good position when we have asphalt classes and stuff for the state. They have a hard time finding a bad road in their town to this way.
Fair enough. Does anybody have any other paving-related questions or comments for Alan?
I just wanted to let him know that a few residents on the Quam have told me how much they like the shoulders where you ground up and use some of the older asphalt to spread that out. It just makes them feel a little bit more comfortable. And the residents in Swanton are a little bit jealous and want to know how you did that. So thank you for making that happen.
Well, you're very welcome. We still have a lot more shoulders to do. Obviously, with this new paving contract, I got a bunch of manholes and stuff like that to get ready before paving. But we will do more shoulder work before the end of the year. Our stroke side mowing, we're trying to get geared up to do our first cut there. So.
No, good job, Alan.
Thank you.
To all the guys, too. Let them know how thrilled we are with all their work, from everybody, from you and John down to the guy holding the weed whacker in the Parks Department. You know, you're all doing excellent work, and we appreciate you showing up every day and working an odd hardest. You're doing a great job. So anything else for Alan or John? Everything good? Are we at town hall? Is everybody set?
Yep.
Okay. That said, Alan, stick around if you like, but you don't have to. John, great work. Keep it up. Thank you. And Carrie, we're on awesome. To the COVID update.
The COVID update. So I listened to 3-4 different state and Franklin County reports. We're all kind of in a holding pattern right now. We're slowly opening. But the report from last Friday from the governor was notable in that he increased, many people have already heard this, but for those that haven't, the max group size from 10 to 25, interior maintenance, which I think that's an interesting title. Things like gyms, massages, and nail salons are open to the delight of many, many people. And town hall continues to operate by appointment only, notably. That probably will change in a week or so, but right now it seems to work pretty well. And Anna's doing a good job scheduling those that need to come in and access both floors. And so, she's doing contact tracing. We're keeping track of all of those people that come in. So if anyone, and so I won't go over the report that I send to the board each week, but know that we are keeping track of what the state and county is doing, other municipalities, and St. Albans Town is open for business. We're not holding anybody back at this point. So I think that's all I'm going to say right now. Any questions?
Do you want to do the town hall relocation update before we hand it off to Anna for a treasurer's report, just so we could move fluently onto schedule?
Yeah, that would be awesome. Yeah, we'd love that. Anna's going to do the treasurer's report. It'll be brief.
Oh, yes, it will be brief. First off, can everybody hear me?
Absolutely.
You can hear.
Okay. Yeah. So I did receive the fourth quarter local options tax, which I meant to send you, the LOT fund. It reflects a period from February 8th of this year to May 13th. It's the largest we've ever received, $194,000, which is great, even during the pandemic. So I wanted everyone to know that. If you want a copy, I can give you a copy. You would like one.
I'd probably go to jail, but that news makes me want to give you a hug, Hannah.
You'll go to jail or I'll go to jail. All right, so
I'm answering that.
As of June 1st today, we are over our fourth tax installment collection. I paid the school their fourth quarter, and our current fund balance as of today is $715,860. So I do have to subtract out, and I think, Aaron, I explained that to you at the end of the year transfer. I do have to subtract out $188,845, of which is going to the fire department reserve and DPW. So currently, we have a fund balance of $527,000, which is great. Our revenues are on track, and our expenditures are below what we budgeted so far. And we have a month left to collect. I have to collect probably around $200,000 more. There is one client in the industrial park that owes $85,000 of that $200,000. So everything that we collect going forward now is going to increase our fund balance. End of year.
Good.
So the short version was that Anna told us we were better off in our fourth quarter revenues than we were at the same time last year, which is good news. People are doing what we hoped, and they're paying their taxes.
It's remarkable.
Yeah.
Can't think of enough. It makes it so much easier.
The Canadians obviously are having a little trouble because they can't cross the border, and most of them have American bank accounts. But they'll be here as soon as they can.
And we should definitely waive any applicable interest and penalties to anybody who was caught across the border. That's, you know, we'll still have a heart. So if anybody does ask,
Brendan, that was awful. I don't know what that was, but we couldn't hear you.
You moved. Oh, you're out. You lost it.
All right, so if you can still, you can still hear me, but we can't hear Brendan.
What about now?
Yes, we can hear you very well.
Okay. So don't move. Anybody who's caught across the border that can't get here to pay their taxes, they should know that we're the type of folk around here that will waive interest and penalties on that.
We heard that part, but now we can't hear you that well at all. You sound like you're very far away.
Okay.
Oh, that's better.
Much better.
Yeah, we don't need to hear that part again. We just need to hear you going forward.
Let's go on to town hall. Does anybody have any questions or comments for Anna? Okay, seeing nobody, let's move on to the town hall relocation update, Carrie. Thank you, Anna. It was great news.
Welcome. Well, so the working group was decided last week. I'm not sure how much you really want to report. You want to report on what we just talked about 20 minutes ago or in general? Because we're moving forward with trying to get that schematic phase done as soon as possible per the vote in March. Because our project manager has advised us and seen evidence of that even as recent as yesterday, that prices are coming in very competitively and we'd like to take advantage of that.
Fair enough. Does anybody have anything else they'd like to add to that update at this time? Okay. So let's move on to schedule. We need to book a meeting, preferably early to mid next week, to start talking in executive session about the police contract proposals. Our RFP deadline was Friday. We received two bids. Carrie and I have sent out some supplemental questions that we will have answered before next week. And we definitely need to get in the same room if possible, or on a Zoom call, and and get that started. So is there anything next week that will not work for anyone that we should, could we start there? Or can we look at maybe Monday? If what works best for you, Carrie?
No night meeting? No. Monday at 4.
So sassy. What about you, Stan? Do you have any? No.
So, I mean, Monday works. I usually keep Mondays free anyway, so you let me know what time works best. 4 o'clock would be great, but I don't know if it's too early, so 5 maybe?
You can make 5 on Monday work.
Yeah, you can do that.
I don't get home till at least 5:15 at the earliest on Monday.
Okay.
You want to do 5:30? Does that give you enough time, Jessica?
Yeah, that'd be fine.
Does that work for everyone?
Yep.
Okay, so 5:30 p.m. Monday night, June 8th.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And there, what are your feelings on trying to do it via Zoom? Or we can do up to, we're not going to have 25 people here. We're going to have 6. But
you're going
to
be in an executive session anyway.
Right, we're going to be in executive session. So you good with coming in the boardroom and sitting at opposite ends of the room?
I'm open either way.
I could do Zoom.
I think I'd be more comfortable with Zoom if we were going to, I think going forward, if we're in the same room together anyways, we should probably be wearing masks.
Mm-hmm.
Probably. Yep.
We have plenty here.
So why don't we do this at Zoom? And then I circulated out some correspondence last week, trying to detail my thoughts on moving the town back to in-person meetings as restrictions are further relaxed. So I'm looking at Monday, June 15th of having the boardroom basically be open to board members, but not have that be any type of a requirement if anybody still wants to Zoom in. Masks should be mandatory in my mind. Exercise social distancing, and then again use Zoom as our vehicle for public participation.
I think my only comment to that, Brendan, is just I think we'd have to figure out the technology piece, because I think when some of us are in the room and some of us are on Zoom, it can get tricky and hard for folks to hear. Whatever we decide, I would recommend we either do all of one thing or all of the other.
Okay, well that's fair. So what, Jonathan, what are your feelings? In person or Zoom on the 15th? Okay, Jessica, for the 15th?
I'm fine with going in person.
Okay, Stanley?
With in person? Are you good with in person on the 15th of June?
Yes,
he is. Just making sure.
Yeah.
They want you to agree to something we didn't clarify.
And then Aaron, are you okay with that?
I'm okay with that. Just to clarify, so we're still having, if we're in person, then the public will be Zooming into the meeting though?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yes, that's my understanding.
Okay. So I'm comfortable with that, and I'll bring my mask.
Good.
Perfect. Okay, but the 8th, next Monday, the 8th at 5:30 will still be via Zoom, and we'll circulate an invitation for that tomorrow.
Correct.
All right, so moving on from schedule. Well, wait a minute. Does the Town Hall Working Committee need to book a meeting? And I think you all are in the room now. Is that something that should happen, you know, within the next 2 weeks, or do you want to do that via email chain in a few days?
I'll probably do that with Matt via email, because he's going to have some testing and he's going to send out that other RFP. So we do need to book it, but we're not static. There's still things that are moving right now.
Fair enough. Okay, thank you. Chair's report. Well, my dog got groomed today before I got a haircut myself, but it is booked for Wednesday at 5 o'clock. Jonathan, I don't know when your appointment is, but other than that, we're excited to see very little to no evidence of community spread in the St. Albans, Franklin County area, and we're excited to be able to see our friends and neighbors go back to work as the governor reopens parts of the economy. Then again, I'll reiterate, George Floyd's death was a murder, and as we meet Monday night, if there's something that we can do to make excessive uses of force part of our contract, maybe it's appropriate to ask that a redacted version of a report be handed to the manager every time there's a use of force in our town? I don't know. We've got to have an ability to allow the town to be part of those discussions. We've had several incidents in the last couple, in the last year or so, and we've kind of hidden behind the blind of that's not our department. It's an agency that we're contracted with. It's the city. You know, they have, they're in charge. Given what can happen and what we've seen, excessive force can turn into murder. And I don't think that the town, whether it's us on the board or a future board in 10 to 20 years, should take a back seat. It should definitely be part of that discussion. So we'll be open to discussing that again in executive session Monday. Other than that, I have nothing, and I hope you all are doing extremely well and thriving. And we're on to other business. Does anybody have any other business? Seeing no hands go up or anybody nod, a motion to adjourn would be excellent at 7:07 p.m.
I'll make a motion. We adjourn the select board meeting of June 1st, 2020.
Very official. I love it.
I'll second it.
Thank you. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Perfect. Thank you. Have a good night, everybody.
You too.